Hello and welcome back to Red Stabler. In this tutorial, we will talk about a really cool automation tool called Browsersync, which can make your web development faster and save you from repetitive manual tasks, such as live reloading the browsers when the code was changed, mirror your action when testing across all browsers and devices, stimulate slower connection for testing site loading performance, and much more. Let's go check it out. Using Browsersync is very easy. First, install Browsersync globally using npm install option G. Then, open a command prompt in your web directory that you want Browsersync to start watching for file change. Then type Browsersync start server files followed by asterisk. This will run Browsersync in server mode to serve the files in this directory. Currently, we are putting the asterisk wildcard at the end, which means to watch for all files in this directory. But you can also watch for a specific file or file types if you like. Once server is up, Browsersync will open it in browser view. If you look at the console, you will see the address on your local machine and also the external address if you want to test on other virtual machine or mobile device. Now I'm going to try changing the CSS of the navigation bar and save the file. You will see that Browsersync will automatically reload the page immediately. Now let's try open it in other browser. If I scroll or click, every browser will do the same. Now, if your site is serving a dynamic content or already have a running server, for example, I have my site running on PHP server on localhost, you can run Browsersync in proxy mode. Just navigate to the web directory, open the command prompt and type Browsersync start proxy localhost file asterisk. Browsersync will wrap your host and provide proxy access to your site. So with this option, you can use Browsersync to test on any web development project like PHP, Spring Boot, and so on. And that is the basic of how to set up and use Browsersync. In the next video, we will dig further in other interesting features of Browsersync. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Please like or subscribe to stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Bye.